On average, half of the energy consumed in buildings goes for heating and cooling. This energy usage can easily be reduced, and just with a few simple optimizations of the building design, we can reach up to 90% energy reduction. My name is Anton Dobrovsky, I'm a bicycle trainer, and in this video I will explain the 6 principles that you have to follow in order to optimize your designs and make very energy efficient buildings. But before focusing on the principles, let's take a step back, look at the big picture, and see why our buildings get cold in winter and hot in summer. Well, heat flows from a warmer to a colder body or environment. And in the winter, our building is warm and the environment is cold, so the heat tries to escape the building. And here comes the main question: how can we avoid this? I'll explain this based on the coffee cup example, and by the way, I'm a huge coffee lover. So when your coffee is in a coffee cup, it gets cold quite fast, right? But when you keep it in a thermal flask, it takes much longer for the coffee to get cold. That's because when the coffee is in the thermal flask, there is no direct contact between the coffee and the cold environment, and the thermal flask is also much better insulated than the coffee cup, so the heat transfer is minimized. The same is with buildings. When all the components and spots through which the building loses energy are optimized, we can drastically reduce the heat losses and optimize its energy usage. So what do you have to optimize in your project? What do you have to do in order to make your building perform like a thermal flask and not like a coffee cup? That's exactly on what the 6 design principles focus on. And by the way, these are also the same principles of the passive house standard, which is the go-to standard for high performance buildings. The first principle is to insulate the building very well. And there should be a single continuous insulation layer all around the roof, the walls, and the floors. The U-value of these components should be around 0.15 watts per square meter Kelvin. And the U-value shows how much heat flows through a component, or in other words, how well the component is insulating. And the lower it is, the better. And with a standard insulation material like mineral wool, you would need around 23 centimeters in order to achieve this U-value. And keep in mind that depending on the size and location of the project, this value will vary, and how to determine what exactly this value should be for your project, I'll mention at the end of the video. The second principle is thermal bridge free design. Thermal bridges are the weak spots in our insulation layer, and wherever something happens with the insulation layer, whether it is interrupted or another material goes through it, these details should be optimized. Thermal bridges are measured with the psi value, and to have a thermal bridge free construction, this value should be less or equal to 0.01 watts per meter Kelvin. By following the first 2 design principles, we created a very well insulated building, but the air can still flow through the building envelope, which can lead to major heat losses, and that's why we have the third principle, which is to make our buildings airtight. Just like with the thermal insulation, there should be a single continuous airtight layer all around the thermal envelope of the building. And this layer, remember, should always be on the hot and humid side of the building. So for cold climates, that's on the inside, and for warm climates, that's on the outside. The fourth principle is high performance windows. These are windows that maximize the energy that we gain from the sun and minimize the energy that we lose through the windows. The average U-value of a high performance window, which again shows how well the window is insulating, is around 0.8 watts per square meter Kelvin. And in most climates, the G-value, also called the solar heat gain coefficient, should be between 0.5 and 0.6, and this value shows us how much energy we gain from the sun. However, these solar gains could be disastrous in the summertime, and that's why we have the fifth principle, which is shading. The shading should be designed in a way to let in the winter sun so that we can utilize the solar gains during the winter, but to block the higher summer sun in order to minimize overheating. And remember, on the south facade, and that's for the northern hemisphere, the shading should be horizontal because that's the place where the sun is high. And on the east and west facades, the shading should be vertical because the sun is very low at these points. So what we did until now is we have made a very well insulated and airtight building. We've optimized all the places, all the spots through which this building loses energy, but we're missing one thing, namely fresh air. And opening the windows to get some fresh air is gonna lead to tremendous heat losses, and it's gonna be also quite uncomfortable. Therefore, we should have a mechanical ventilation with heat recovery. This is a system that continuously brings outdoor air into the building and extracts air to the outside, but the outgoing air gives off the heat to the air that comes in from the outside, and in this way we minimize the heat losses through the ventilation system while constantly having fresh and filtered air inside of the building. And in a very energy efficient building or a high performance building, these systems should have an efficiency of at least 75%. And remember, you shouldn't blindly follow these principles or just use some of them. because you're not gonna get the desired energy reduction, or even worse, you might make a building which is not comfortable or even healthy to live in. Therefore, you should combine all the principles together and make an energy model to see how much insulation you need, what kind of windows to choose, etc. And that's exactly what we do as passive house professionals when we design high performance buildings. All we know to make a very energy efficient building or a passive house building, we use the fabric first approach. We want to optimize the building envelope or the building fabric in order to minimize the heat losses, because that's where we lose the energy from. And by using the fabric first approach, we can reach 90% reduction for the energy used for heating and cooling. And in the next videos, I'll focus on each of these principles separately. I'll go a bit more in depth. So if you're interested to learn more, make sure to click the button below and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and see you next time.